Working part-time jobs for pocket money is a rite of passage for many teenagers. But in the cost of living crisis, some teens are now facing impossible choices between staying in school and supporting their families. Indira Stewart met some teenagers working upwards of 30 hours a week and looks at the desperate measures schools are taking to try and keep them in class.
Take one. Action.
Jaylen and Nevaeh are 16 years old, born and raised in Ōtara and best friends.
Growing up with my family was really fun. And there was hard times where I could see my parents struggling.
I feel like my parents, they tried to like keep me away from seeing that, like that side of like their financial situations and stuff.
They've been students at Sir Edmund Hillary Collegiate in Ōtara since they were 5 years old. An 11-year friendship still going strong, from school friends to work colleagues.
I usually get changed here at school, in the toilets, in my work uniform.
I mainly work about 20 to 23 hours, and the most hours I've worked, 35, 37 hours during a school week. Yeah, I don't know how I did it. I was just so like, whoa. I worked this whole time and I'm still at school.
Nevaeh's average working hours are similar. That's about 3 to 4 weeknight shifts plus a Saturday shift.
Working after school, like four to 10, and then coming home and like finishing off assessments that I couldn't do while I was working. And yeah, that would take me till like midnight too, or going 1 or 2. Free the latest.
Normally you go sleep at midnight or even 1 o'clock to like catch up with homework even. So sometimes it'll be later, maybe 2 a.m., 3 a.m. from doing assessments after work.
This is the juggle that many students here are facing, but they're among the hardest working youth in the country and they're doing it for family.
The money I earn from working really helps my family, especially paying for our like rent and our power and water, because it's really expensive nowadays. My parents are both full-time workers, but whatever they got left is not enough to pay off our rent. So that's when I come in with the money that I've earned to just help them and like to make sure that they're not alone on this. So I managed to buy my own uniform, my own stationery, even my brother's uniform, because I have a little brother here. They were just like, oh, you didn't have to do this. Like, this isn't your job to provide for us. It's their job to provide for us and my siblings. But, I just wanted to thank them in a way that I could, yeah.
To Nevaeh and Jaylen, family is everything.
My family, they're like a big part of my life. And I just want to give back to them, because... provided for me, even when times are hard. Yeah, they always kept the roof over my head, kept me warm, kept me fed.
I kind of relate to Jaylen too, like giving back to them and knowing it was hard for them when they came from the islands and like trying to like fit in with like the other people here and learning the language was pretty hard.
These are the stories that New Zealand's record low attendance rates don't tell. They're stories that principals Kiri Tuketo and Soana Pāmaka see every day.
The challenge is that the reality for a lot of our young people is not understood by a lot of New Zealand society. And our young people are very, very loyal to family. Mm. So if it comes down to the choice of school or work, they will work. It's not a choice that any 15-year-old should have to make. But, you know, that's what our young people have to make, and that's then what we, as the school, have to support so that they can do both.
But doing both is tough, and it means Soana, Kiri and their staff go above and beyond what the Education Ministry requires, Tāmaki College runs Saturday classes throughout the year to help students catch up. Both schools allow flexible learning so that students can learn from home on particular days.
What we try and do is we try not to be the barrier. We try not to punish those kids. We need to actually stand up and be the face of the numbers that they're reading out in Wellington. Well, we have to be the hope. We have to say, okay, so if you're going to work maybe 3 days a week and come to school 2 days a week, does the attendance really matter to the people in Wellington? Or does it matter to your well-being and your family's well-being, because you're happy, your family's happy?
I mean, you guys know, are you still gonna...
That's not a hypothetical story. We met one of Kitty's students who only attends school 2 days a week because she needs to work.
We will be working twice, three times as hard to give the students the same opportunity as any other student that would be at school 5 days a week. And I tell you what, that student will turn up every day on those 2 days that they come to school. They won't miss those 2 days.
But Kitty knows she can't solve every problem, and that's a tough reality to live with.
I had a student in year 13 who was cleaning with her family, and so she'd start at 7 p.m. and finish at 7 a.m. And one particular day, she had work at 7 p.m. and finished work at 7 a.m., which was the day of her English, level 3 English exam. And she turned up to the exam and she was tired. So she absent-mindedly grabbed a book, a piece of reefer, and in there was a paper that dropped out, was to remind her of something. And straight away she was pulled out and told that she had cheated. And in that split second, I don't know, but I guess if I was there and able to talk to the examination person, I would have said, she hasn't slept. The fact that she turned up to the exam is good enough. And so this child had missed out on her external NCEA Level 3 English exam. And so now she works at Rainbow's End. What did she really want to do? She wanted to do law.
Tāmaki College is about 30 minutes' drive east of Sir Edmund Hillary Collegiate. With the rising cost of living, Soana says more of her students are feeling the impacts.
I work 25 to 30 hours per week.
I work 25 to 30 per hours a week.
25, 26 hours a week.
The most I've ever worked was 40 to 50 hours a week.
The most hours I've worked in a week would approximately be 47. I do work night shift.
I still come to school, like in the mornings. So I go home, get changed and come straight back here.
One time we went out and spoke to the community and they gave us a little bit of money, and we used that little bit of money to go and negotiate with employers to release the young person for a day
from work.
And then we would use that money to pay them the equivalent of their wages if they had been at work, so that they can come to school. Mm. Teachers have paid for power bill, teachers have paid for a device, teachers have paid for shoes, the school uniform, stationery. And you know, it's always sometimes, don't tell my mum, but you know, are you able to, because our power bill may be cut, and you know. Yeah, we do. Mm. You know, because what are you going to do? You are going to help. I don't want people to listen to this and judge, because the reason why we're doing this is to improve understanding of the reality of our young people. And we're doing this with the utmost respect to our young people and their families. We have beautiful children. They're so smart, intelligent, full of capabilities. They love school. Not a single one of our students doesn't want to be successful.
Absolutely.
It's words like these that keep students like Jalen and Nevaeh coming back to school with big dreams.
My future pathway or career that I would want to do in the future is to become an architect.
I really want to become a doctor or like a radiologist, to give back to my family, my people in the islands.
If I had $1 million, I would help my family pay off all our like bills and that, so they don't have to feel stressed about it.
I, like, give some money to my grandparents especially. I would get us a house that we can fit in.
A big house for me and my siblings to stay in, so we can all have a room each.
Yeah, just give the money to my family.